would you if he walked into the room? What would you say if he walked into the room? How would you praise if he walked into the room? How would you shout if he walked into the room? How would you shout if he walked into the room? What would you do if he walked?
Your healer's in the room. Your savior's in the room. Your provider's in the room. Your redeemer's in the room. Your champion's in the room. He's in this room. So what will you do?
Hi everyone, welcome to International Mission Fellowship again. Once again, thank you so much for signing up to pray, to join a prayer chain on Saturdays from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Let us continue to pray, pray for pandemic, pray for economic crisis, and pray for the law and order here in our nations and the nations of the world. And once again, thank you so much for joining us for the worship. I pray and hope that you will be challenged, motivated, and blessed today. Let us continue worship.
We want to say welcome again from the Sani household. We want to also say how much we love you guys and miss you. We look forward so much to worshiping together again. And we're praying that everyone is well and that those who are ill will be healed. Most of all, just remember that we love you as God loves us. Should we pray together now? Father, thank you so much for our church family and that even when we're not in the same building, we can be together. Thank you, Father, for your Holy Spirit that joins us all together. We thank you for him in this time that we're apart, that you still blend our hearts together in one voice to lift up praise to you. Be with everyone, Father, as they go through these trials. Help them and bless them and help them to know of your presence. We especially pray for those that have been ill, that you'll heal them, Father. Thank you for our leadership, for Say and Jean and Pastor Andy and all those that are in leadership, Father, that you be with them and help them and bless their families. Thank you, Father, for our country, and I pray that you will be with our country during this time, and you will let truth reign, and that we would remember the things that are founded on you and on your word that have led us all these years, that those things may still lead us, Father. Thank you once again for your love. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. So God bless you today.
You give life, you are love, you bring light to darkness. You give hope, you restore every heart that's broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath. Every heart that's
So we pray.
heart will shout your praise. Our heart will cry, this bone will sing, great are you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Forever me is gone.
Today I want to preach on John chapter 4.
ဒီကနေ့မှာတော့ကျွန်တော်ရှင်ယောဟန်ခန်းကြီး၄ကျောင်းကိုပြောချင်ပါတယ
်. In John chapter 4, Jesus was coming with his disciples and then stopped by in Samaria.
ဒီနေရာမှာဆိုလို့ရှင်ယေရှုခရစ်တော်ကတွေ့တပည့်တော်တွေနဲ့လာပြီးတော့မှယေရှုခရစ်တော်ကရှမာရိမှာခဏရပ်နေတာဖြစ်တယ်.
While the disciples went in the city, Jesus was waiting in the well.
ဒီတပည့်တော်တွေကမြို့ထဲမှာခဏရှိနေတဲ့အချိန်မှာသူယေရှုခရစ်တော်ကရေတွင်းသားမှာရှိနေပါတယ်
။ While he was sitting there, a Samaritan woman showed up to fetch water.
အဲ့ဒီရေတွင်းသားမှာရှိနေတဲ့အချိန်မှာရှမာရိအမျိုးသမီးရေခတ်ဖို့ရန်အတွက်ရောက်ရှိလာပါတယ်
။ And Jesus talked to her and then the conversation started to talk about salvation.
ပြီးတော့မှအဲ့ဒီနေရာမှာယေရှုခရစ်တော်ကဒီအမျိုးသမီးနဲ့စကားပြောပြီးတော့မှဒီစကားပြောဆွေးနွေးတဲ့အရာလေးဖြစ်ပေါ်လာခဲ့တယ်
။ And the Samaritan woman knew that Jesus was someone special or even Messiah.
ပြီးတော့ဒီရှမာရိအမျိုးသမီးကယေရှုခရစ်တော်ကထူးခြားတဲ့လူတစ်ယောက်ဖြစ်တယ်၊သူဟာမေရှိယတစ်ယောက်ဖြစ်တယ်ဆိုပြီးတော့မှသိသွားခဲ့ပါတယ်
။ And immediately she went to the city.
ပြီးတော့မှသူချက်ချင်းပဲမြို့ထဲကိုသွားလိုက်တယ်
In verse 39 to 41, it says, Many of the Samaritans from the dead town believe in him, in Jesus, because of the woman's testimony. He told me everything I ever did. So when the Samaritans came to him, to Jesus, they urged him to stay with them, and he stayed 2 days. And because of his words, many more became believers. They said to the woman,We no longer believe just because of what you say. Now we have heard for ourselves, and we know that this man really is the savior of the world.
ဒီအငယ်39ကနေ41တဲ့42ကိုကျွန်တော်ဖတ်ပါမယ်။ရှမာရိမိမကကျွန်ုပ်ပြုဘူးတမျှတော်အမှုအရာတို့ကိုတူတီထုတ်ဖော်ပြီးဟုတတ်တခံတော်စကားကြောင့်ထိုမျိုး၌နေသောရှမာရိလူအများတို့သည်ယေရှုကိုယုံကြည်ကြ၏ထိုကြောင့်ရှမာရိလူတို့သည်အထံတော်သို့ရောက်လင်မိမိတို့အရက်၌နေတော်မူမီအကြောင်းတောင်းပန်ကြ၏ထိုအရက်၌နရက်နေတော်မူ၏အခြားသောသူအများတို့သည်နှုတ်ကပတ်စကားတော်ကြောင့်ယုံကြည်၍ထိုမိမအားကျွန်ုပ်ယခုဖြစ်လျင်ငါတို့သည်တင်ဤစကားကြောင့်သာယုံကြည်သည်မဟုတ်စကားတော်ကိုယုံကိုယ်တိုင်ကြားနာရ၍ဤသူသည်လောကီသားတို့ကိုကယ်တင်တော်မူသောသခင်တည်းဟုသောခရစ်တော်အမှန်စင်စစ်ဖြစ်တော်မူကြောင်းကိုသိသည်ဟုဆိုကြ၏
Palestine is only about 120 miles from north to south
Palestine ဟာဆိုလို့ရှင်မြောက်ကနေတောင်ကိုမိုင်120ရှည်လျားတာဖြစ်တယ
် and it's divided into 3 territories
ပြီးတော့မှအဲ့ဒီ120မိုင်ထဲမှာဆိုလို့ရှင်ရင်းနယ်မြေ3ပိုင်းခြားနားထားပါတယ
် On the south is Judea and on the north is Galilee
တောင်ဘက်မှာဆိုလို့ရှင်တော့ Judea ဖြစ်ပြီးတော့မှမြောက်ဘက်မှာဆိုလို့ရှင်တော့ Galilee ရှိပါတယ
် And in between it's Samaria
အဲ့ဒီအလယ်မှာဆိုလို့ရှင်ရှမာရိရှိပါတယ
် So in order to go from Judea to Galilee sometime they have to pass by Samaria
အဲ့တော့ဒီဂါလယူဒပင်နဲ့ဂါလိလဲကိုသွားဖို့ရန်အတွက်ကသူတို့ကရှမာရိကိုဖြတ်သွားရတာဖြစ်တယ်
။ If they go through Samaria it took about 3 days.
ရှမာရိမြို့ကိုဖြတ်သွားမယ်ဆိုလို့ရှင်တော့ရက်3ရက်အချိန်ကြာတယ်
။ But a lot of Jews wouldn't go through Samaria because Samaria was a mixed races so they would go through the river of Jordan.
ဒါပေမဲ့ဒီဂျူးလူမျိုးအများဟာဆိုလို့ရှင်တော့ရှမာရိမျိုးကိုဖြတ်ပြီးမသွားပါဘူး။ဘာကြောင့်လဲဆိုတော့ဒီရှမာရိကယောနောနေတဲ့မျိုးတစ်မျိုးဖြစ်တဲ့အတွက်ကြောင့်မလို့သူတို့ကအဲ့ဒီမျိုးကိုရှောင်ပြီးတော့မှသွားကြတယ်
။ And if they do that it took 6 days at least 6 days.
အဲ့ဒီလိုရှောင်ပြီးတော့မှသွားမယ်ဆိုလို့ရှင်တော့6ရက်လောက်ကြာတာဖြစ်တယ်
။ So when Jesus met the woman the Samaritan woman it's very interesting because Jesus knew about her.
ယေရှုခရစ်တော်ကဒီအမျိုးသမီးနဲ့တွေ့တဲ့အချိန်မှာအင်မတန်မှစိတ်ဝင်စားစရာကောင်းပါတယ်။ဘာကြောင့်လဲဆိုတော့ယေရှုခရစ်တော်ကသူ့ရဲ့အကြောင်းကိုသိနေပြီးသားဖြစ်နေတယ်
။ You know, I want to point out a few things about witnessing.
ဒီထဲကနေပြီးတော့မှကျွန်တော်တက်တေခံခြင်းအကြောင်းနဲ့ပတ်သက်ပြီးနည်းငယ်ပြောချင်ပါတယ်
။ What is witnessing?
တက်တေခံခြင်းဆိုတာဘာလဲ?
Witnessing is about lifestyle.
တတိခံခြင်းဆိုတာကလူနေမှုပုံစံဖြစ်တယ
်။ In verse 34, Jesus said, "My food is to do the will of him who sent me and to accomplish his work."
အငယ်34ထဲမှာယေရှုကငါ့ကိုဆေလွတ်တော်မူသောသူ၏အလိုတော်ကိုဆောင်ခြင်း၊သူ၏အမှုတော်ကိုပြီးစီးခြင်းအမှုတည်းငါအစားစရာဖြစ်၏လို့ဆိုထားပါတယ်
။ Eating food is natural.
အစားစားခြင်းဆိုတာတဘာဝဖြစ်တယ်
။ We never forget to eat food.
စားဖို့ရန်အတွက်ကျွန်တော်တို့လုံးဝမမေ့ပါဘူ
း We never forget how to eat food
ဒီအစာကိုဘယ်လိုစားရမလဲဆိုတာကိုကျွန်တော်တို့မမေ့ပါဘူ
း Our body needs it
ကျုပ်ခန္ဓာကလိုအပ်နေတာဖြစ်တယ
် You know it is something we do every day
အဲ့ဒီအရာဆိုလို့ရှင်ကျွန်တော်တို့နေ့တိုင်းလုပ်နေရတဲ့အရာတစ်ခုဖြစ်တယ
် We eat mostly breakfast lunch and dinner
အထူးသဖြင့်ကျွန်တော်တို့မနက်စာနေ့လယ်စာညနေစာစားလေးရှိကြတယ
် No one said I'm fed up of eating food and stop eating
ဘယ်သူကမှငါအစာစားရညင်းငွေသွားပြီဆိုပြောမှအစာမစားဘဲနေတဲ့သူမရှိပါဘူ
း Likewise witnessing sharing the good news to others should be in our lifestyle
ဒီလိုပဲကျွန်တော်တို့ရဲ့ဘဝတက်တံမှာလဲသူတပါးထာမှာကိုယ်တက်သေးခံခြင်းဟာဆိုလို့ရှင်ကိုယ့်ရဲ့ဘဝရဲ့လူနေမှုပုံစံတစ်ခုဖြစ်နေရမှာဖြစ်တယ
် It is not an option for believers it is a must
ဒါဟာဆိုလို့ရှင်ယုံကြည်သူတွေအတွက်ရွေးချယ်စရာမဟုတ်ပါဘူးလုပ်ရမယ့်အရာတစ်ခုဖြစ်တယ
် You know once a person was asked what his profession was
တချင်ကလူတစ်ယောက်ကိုမေးခဲ့ကြတယ်သူ့ရဲ့အလုပ်ကဘာလဲလို့မေးတယ
် He said my profession is witnessing the good news to others
သူကဘာပြောလဲဆိုလို့ရှင်ငါရဲ့အလုပ်ဟာဆိုလို့ရှင်သူတပါးကိုတည်င်းကောင်းဝေငှခြင်းဖြစ်တယ်လို့ပြောပါတယ်
But I earn my livelihoodby becoming a doctor.
ဒါပေမဲ့ကျောရဲ့အသက်ရှင်ဖို့ရအတွက်တော့ဆရာဝန်လုပ်နေတာဖြစ်ပါတယ်လို့ပြောတယ်
။ And witnessing is about breaking barriers.
ပြီးတော့တက်တည်ခံခြင်းဆိုတာဟာလည်းအသားစီးတွေကိုဖြတ်တောက်ခြင်းဖြစ်ပါတယ်
။ There are so many barriers today in and around us.
ဒီကနေ့မှာဆိုလို့ရှင်ကျောရဲ့ပဝင်းကျင်မှာအသားစီးတွေမြောက်များစွာရှိတာဖြစ်တယ်
။ There is barriers between rich and poor.
ချမ်းသာသူနဲ့ဆင်းရဲသူတွေရဲ့ကြားထဲကအသာစီးရှိတယ်
။ There's a cultural barriers.
ပြီးလို့ရှင်ယဉ်ကျေးမှုဆိုင်ရာသားစီးမှုတွေရှိတယ်
။ And there is social status.
ပြီးရောမှလူအဆင့်အတန်းခွဲခြားမှုရှိတယ်
။ When Jesus talked to the Samaritan woman, he was breaking the barrier.
ယေရှုခရစ်တော်ကဒီရှမာရိအမျိုးသမီးနဲ့စကားပြောတဲ့အခါမှာအသာစီးတွေကိုဖြတ်တောက်ခြင်းဖြစ်နေတယ
်။ Because forHundreds and hundreds of years, the Jews would not hang out with the Samaritans.
ဘာကြောင့်လဲဆိုတော့နှစ်ပေါင်းရာနဲ့ချီရှိခဲ့ပြီဖြစ်တဲ့ဂျူးတွေဟာရှမာရိတွေနဲ့ဆက်ဆံမှုမရှိတာဟာ
You know, the Samaritans were Jews before, but when the Assyrian king conquered, they start marrying foreigners.
ဒီရှမာရိတွေဟာဆိုလို့ရှင်တစ်ချိန်တုန်းကဂျူးတွေဖြစ်ပါတယ်ဒါပေမဲ့ဒီအာရှုရိတိုင်းပြည်ကသူတို့ကိုတိမ့်ပိုက်ပြီးတဲ့အခါမှာသူတို့ကတခြားနိုင်ငံသားတွေနဲ့လက်ထပ်သွားကြဖြစ်ပါတယ
် And eventually they became an impure race
အဲ့တော့သူတို့ကဒီလိုမျိုးရောနှောတဲ့လူမျိုးတစ်ခုဖြစ်သွားခဲ့တယ
် So the Jews didn't want to hang out with Samaritans
ဒါကြောင့်မို့လို့ဂျူးလူမျိုးတွေကဒီရှမာရိလူမျိုးတွေနဲ့လုံးဝအတူမရှိခြင်းဘူး
It is said that, you know, when the Jews actually get married with another race, then that person is going to be disowned by the families.
ဘာပြောလဲဆိုလို့ရှင်ဒီဂျူးလူမျိုးတယောက်ကတခြားတိုင်းတစ်ပါးသားနဲ့လက်ထပ်သွားပြီဆိုလို့ရှင်တော့သူတို့ရဲ့မိသားစုကနေပြောမှသူ့ကိုစွန့်လွတ်လိုက်တယ်လို့ဆိုပါတယ
်။ Jesus broke the barrier.
ယေရှုခရစ်တော်ကဒီအသားစီးကိုချိုးဖျက်လိုက်ပါတယ်
။ We cannot...be witnessing about good news without breaking barriers today
ဒီကနေ့မှလည်းကျွန်တော်တို့ကအသားစီးတွေကိုကြော်ဖြတ်ဖို့ရန်အတွက်ပေါ့နော်တည်ငြိမ်ကောင်းအားဖြင့်ဒါလည်းလှုပ်ဆောင်နိုင်မှာဖြစ်တယ
် In the eyes of God there is no difference between colors and races
ဘုရားရှင်ရဲ့အမြင်တော်မှာဆိုလို့ရှင်တော့ကျောအားလုံးဟာဆိုလို့ရှင်ရင
် every human beingis a child of God
လူအားလုံးဟာဆိုလို့ရှင်ဘုရားရဲ့သားသမီးဖြစ်တယ
် and why witnessing why should we share the good news to others
Because
it transforms life.
The
Word of God changes
life. There
are so many people who need to transform their lives.
You know,
the government tried to force people to change their life, but it hardly succeed. The true transformation of lives comes from God.
That's
why we need to share the good news to those people.
The
Samaritan woman changed her priority after meeting Jesus.
The
Bible says she left her water pot and then went back to the city.
After
she met Jesus, her priority became Jesus alone.
And she
also changed her attitude about herself.
She had a
loose character, and so people around that city didn't have a lot of respect for her.
Some
scholars say that the fact that she showed up at noontime when there's no one would be there to get water shows that she was ashamed of herself.
Lila Turia, Lila Che, Yaba, Piola Solution, Diamutami, Monte, Chema, to Yekala, Suraga, Tuga Mutema, to Yekapoya, to Shichau, to Tajang, to Eri Chema, Yavla, Piedelu Piovare.
But after she met Jesus, she was not ashamed anymore.
Dabime to Yeshukadone, to Pida Kama, to Yeshachau Chene Mashirobu.
Instead, she went to the city and talked about Jesus to those people.
Mashachau Dobene, to her solution. And
she also changes her influence. Before she met Jesus, she also had some influence, but in a bad way.
After
she met Jesus, she started influencing lots of people from the city.
That's
why it is so important for us to share the good news to other people.
There are
people who need to set their priorities straight.
There are
people who need to change their attitude.
There are
people who need to change the way how they influence other people. You know, it is one of the survey or research says that even an introvert influenced at least 10,000 people in her lifetime. So it is important for us and for everyone to influence others in a good way. So nothing can truly transform others except by the Word of God.
Erilum Pilazi Puya Adraga de Piaulemu Pila Puya Adraga Yish Piashin Tama Bepibare.
We have seen so many bad things and so many things that we don't like.
Joru Manita de Ayari Makone Ayari Miaswa Pipore.
You cannot go and fix it.
Eri Yarigo Jo Tuapio Matupian Lomayabao.
The best way to do is through the Word of God. Once a person accepts Jesus as their personal Savior, it will change their life. So today, it is so important for us to share the Word of God and to be a witness.
Now,
how do we witness? How to witness? First, there should not be any prejudice about people. When Jesus talk to the Samaritan woman, Jesus as a God, I think, knew her background and what she had been doing.
The Yeshu Christo ga shamari myo tami ne saka pyo de akha ma Yeshu ha phaya phit de a le yaw bo no di myo tami ba re phit khet de le so tu ye a chang go ti bi da phit de.
But Jesus still treat her as a normal person.
Da bi me Yeshu Christo ga tu go ta ma lu ti yaw lo be tu sat san ne.
You know, there's a story that the rabbis forbade a rabbi to greet a woman in public.
And a rabbi
would not even speak to his wife or sister or daughter in public. There were even the Pharisees called the bruised and the bleeding Pharisees, because when they see women coming, they close their eyes, they shut their eyes, and then they hit on the walls and the houses.
Back
then, for a rabbi to speak with a woman in public was the end of his reputation.
And
yet, Jesus was speaking to a woman. Not only was a woman, but she was a loose character. But Jesus reach out to her.
Yeshu Christo tu ne sat san pyo so khe de.
You know, when it comes to witnessing, there should not be any discrimination.
Tat te khan chin phit la de a kha ma si yin mu de ma shi ya ba wo.
We must talk about God to every human being.
Joru ga phaya ye a chang tia ko lu a yauk chin si dai lu dai ko pyo wa ma phit par de.
And the second thing is, tell your own story.
Duriya acha solution ko ye a chang ko pyo ba.
The best way to tell the good news is your own experience about God.
The din kaung ko we nga chin ye a kaung song a ya ha solution no ko ye a chang ko be pyo ya chin phit de.
That's what this woman did. She said in verse 41, he told me all the things that I have done. When you tell your own story, people won't argue you. And don't try to convince people. It is not our job to convince or convict people to Christ. It is the job of the Holy Spirit to do that.
Choro lo ya me aloha so lo shin lu de ko twa pyo ma si yong tain twa apit tin twa pho ma houp ba wo. Phya thakin da ha so lo shin tan shin no wit nin naw ga lou saung ya me aya phit de.
That's why it says it is no longer because of what you said that we believe, for we have heard for ourselves and know that this one is indeed the Savior of the world. Share your story, share about God, and the Holy Spirit will convict the people. Sometimes we worry that we may not know about the Bible, we may not be good enough, we may not have a skill to convince people.
But
the best way to witness is telling your own story, what God has done in your life, and people will receive it well. So, witnessing is a natural thing to do for believers. You know, as our physical body is strengthened by the food that we are taking in, our spiritual life is strengthened and renewed when we do witnessing. Remember, you don't have to go overseas or you don't have to cross another state to do to share the word of God. People are observing the way how you talk, the way how you treat them, the way how you serve. Everywhere, anytime, wherever you are actually witnessing. There is an urgency to witness to other people. You know, there's a few statistics that I want to share with you. A survey found that almost half of the Americans from between 18 and 34 do not identify themselves as any particular religion.
The American, but not American, the could have at the session again, those are lay her solution in it, the well of her solution, to go to beba diet, nema, sesamo machine, bulu to popiare.
And there was a burner group survey, and it reveals that less than 1% of the Americans between ages 18 and 23 hold a biblical worldview.
Piromadi bana osu ye lila che ye di sita aya solution turu atasashi negane biomana selene ha solution ye ma solution ye di tia kaino out talen puya ye.
And according to that same survey, the percentage of Americans who call themselves Christian has dropped at least 11% since
1990. Go Korean Balo, Pure to her solution, yes, Sati Yaga, no Lago, Jasin, Tora, Pibare, Tongua, Gozegane, Pioma.
On the contrary, the other religions show large gains in the survey. And Olson's research also found that the percentage of Americans that attend church is about 18.7%.
Biroma Olson yet Lela Mo Aya solution, the American Mapiajong Tete Lu Uyeha solution, Sashit Dedemakon Yakai no Meshi de Lupiobare.
And he also said that if the trends continue by 2050, half of that person is going to be attending church.
The Gelo Mia D. Say, Attain that set Twane Keme, D. Tainly that set Twane Keme solution, Natown Nase Kune solution, you know, Piajang Tete Lu Uya, a coot at the web, Beshina Lame Lupiobare.
And unfortunately, the fastest growing group is the non believers.
The Bime Kamakons of Baptist solution, no, Ali Amyan to Shane to Totanere Yagar of Mayongi to repute.
Just in 10 years, between 1990 and 2001, their population, their numbers goes up from 14 million to 29 million.
The Tangoya goes again in a town that Jahadega Senate Jahadwemabe to do her solution. She, the Jahadema, but not to look at Miai, who meant the Lara Gojo to Yamapibari.
And Joseph McDowell, who has worked for the Campus Crusade for Christ since 1964, says that 94% of high school graduates leave their faith within 2 years.
Piroma di Joseph McDowell sure tu ha solution no tuga di Campus Crusade loaded to the pide tuga ba pyo le solution di 94 ya kai nong do athat tan chang pi twar de tu re ha so lo shin na ni atwa ma tu ro ye yong ji mu re ko swet lut twar de lo pyo ba de.
So in verse 35 it says, Jesus says, do you not say there are yet 4 months and then comes the harvest? Behold, I say to you, lift up your eyes and look on the fields, that they are white for harvest.
This
is a time for believers to step up and share the good news.
The Achen has solution, Yongji to Anenesa Pioma, the Dingang Winga Puya to Achen Kong Pipare.
You know, recently, look around what happened, not only here in our state and nation, but the nations of the world. There are so many things that happen.
A good Loli Mabe Pitware, a Yale, Kuya, Pawinjin Kuya, Pine Tema Bemho, Kuya Nangan Tema Bemho, the Gabaloma Pipianir, Yaraku Chijaba.
The harvest is indeed ready.
Sabari has solution yet thing for yandra win win pitney
baby. We must pray harder.
Joe Pobio must suit down yama pite.
And we must share the word of God more than ever before.
Piyayet no kapadogo a yingata Pobio majoro winga puyandra lu adapted bare.
Remember, it is through our lifestyles that we share the word of God.
It is the way
we treat other
people.
People need life transformation.
And
it is only through God, it is only through the power of the blood of Jesus that life can be truly and permanently transformed.
Area Puyadakin, Crito, yet a Twido, Archin, Dalin, the Boata Daga, to get Simane, Bianle Mugu Pima Pede.
Let us share that powerful message and good news to others.
The Jok the Dinko, the Goji at the Dinko, Winga Jaya, on Piyat, Nokapadogu Winga Jaya.
May God give us burden.
Piyadakin, I judge Marugo, the deep
be my God challenges.
Piyadakin, judge Marugo, Mebe Usambazi.
And may God use us to touch someone's life.
Amen.
Amen.
There is a king seated among us. Let every heart receive him now. there is praise, he will inhabit, and there will be grace and mercy all around. Every burden will be lifted in his presence. Every trophy will be laid down at his feet. There is a name that reigns above all others, Jesus Christ, the King above all.
What would you do if he walked into the room, what would you say? If he walked into the room, how would you praise? If he walked into the room, how would you shout? If he walked into the room, how would you shout? If he walked into the room, what would you do? If he walked into the room, yes, what would you do?
Your healer's in the room. Your Savior's in the room. Your Provider's in the room. Your Redeemer's in the room. Your Champion's in the room. He's in this room. So what will you do? Jesus Christ, the King above all kings.